Hey people, what is up? Alright guys, how many of you out there like a girl with a nice in-shape black ass? Exacto, what the fuck did you just say? I'll say it again. I said, how many of you out there like Benchmade black class? Well, that's what I got right here. I'm going to show it to you. I'm going to talk about it, ramble, let y'all know what I think about it. You know, same shit, different toilet. Exacto, would you please quit talking about black asses and toilets and just show us the fucking knife? Okay. So what I got is the Benchmade Bedlam. Now, some of you may know, if you watch previous videos where I talk about it, I don't dislike it, but I am not the biggest fan of the Axis lock. Okay? It's not a bad lock. As a matter of fact, it's a really strong lock. However, I do think it has a potential weakness. I've not encountered it myself. It could be a paranoia on my part. However, I do see something that could be a potential weakness. Now what that is, I'm not going to dwell on it, but inside here you have a couple of Omega springs that keep the tension on the lock bar, keeps it going forward onto the back of that, you know, the tang or whatever of the blade. When it opens up, that bar shoots forward. Those Omega springs keep it forward at all times. Well, if you stress the knife out a lot, like I said, I've never seen it personally, but if those Omega springs go, then your bar is just moving back and forth in that channel and you really have no lock. So I see that as a potential weakness. Honestly, it's unfounded right now, but like I said, it could be a paranoia. That, and you know, I'm just used to other locks. So that being said, you know, it's not a bad lock. It's a great lock as far as strength. And, you know, it's fairly easy to use. I'll show you, you know, how to make it a little easier. But regardless of what lock this knife had, I mean, this knife could have, you know, any type of lock, and I would love it. So I'm going to go around the knife, and I'm going to tell you about it, what I think about it, you know, my feelings on it. First of all, the most obvious at the moment, at least for me, look at that handle. That's one of the first reasons I fell in love with this knife. And when I'm talking about falling in love, I'm talking about like I fell in love with Millie. I'm falling in love with her. Like that. Different reasons. Now, this is a knife right here that I just might go to jail over. You'll see what I mean in a minute. She's a sweet girl to go to jail over. But, look at that. That's like a organic, it's almost like a leather or some kind of animal hide. It's just a really nice texture. I like it. It don't do a whole lot for grip. I mean, it's not like, you know, a cold steel G10 or some of the Spyderco G10. It's not like that grippy. It is a G10, but it's a smoother, you know, just a textured G10. Not like a checkered or, you know, it's not real grippy is what I'm saying. Now, I don't think that really matters. You've got a good blade or a good handle shape right here, so that does well for grip, and you got good jimping, which I'll show you in a minute. Now, how do you open this knife? Now, a lot of you knife guys, you already know. Y'all know how this knife opens, and y'all already know what I'm talking about gel. Well, see, in my state, this type of knife right here is illegal to carry because you don't have no thumb stud or thumb disc or thumb hole or anything like that. You pull this little Axis lock back and the blade comes out. That's an auto Axis. So this is an automatic knife. Now, you've seen I did it with one hand there. Like that. One side. Okay, you can do it over here. Like a trigger, you know, you can pull it out of your pocket and trigger it with just this finger. So it works well. Now the reason it works well, it is a little gritty on me right now, but there's a reason for that as well. I hope y'all love me because I done made my shit gritty for y'all so I could demonstrate something. See right there? That little axis peg or whatever you want to call it. You know, the head of the bar. It rides on these two little channels. The little circular part rides along those two little channels on both sides. Well, what I find is it don't come like this from the factory, at least mine didn't, and a lot of my Benchmades that I tried with the Axis, it didn't come like this. But what you want to do is you want to just throw your little bit of oil down in there on those right there. See where I'm putting the needle? Not a whole lot. You don't want to get lint and shit built up, but just throw your little bit of oil in there, okay? And kind of work it around, you know, move the lock back and forth, kind of get that oil going. And what that'll do is that'll make it smooth where you can open it with one hand, one finger, either side. Because if it's real dry, it'll be kind of gritty. And sometimes when it's real dry, you got to pull it, one side will hang up on you, and it'll kind of do a little thing like this. It'll kind of, you know, twist a little bit, and it won't want to open with one hand, one finger, I mean. You know, it'll kind of torque in there. So if you oil it up, it'll be nice and smooth. And it just, you know, it works better for me. I like the nice smoothness. Now, enough of that. Let's talk about the rest of the knife. Now, as you see, it comes out pretty quick. It's got a pretty strong spring in there. Either side, you can open it. If you pull it out of your pocket, chances are you're going to have it like that, right? You carry it in your pocket on the clip. Just pull it out. Your finger's already kind of close to that. You just reach up. You know, pull it back, trigger it back. Alternately, you can pull out of your pocket. If your thumb's right there, just kind of reach up, pull back. Or you can do the two-finger pinch like that. Okay? So, you know, it's a pretty quick knife to deploy. You know, it's just, it's an automatic. You know, if you're familiar with automatics, most of them are pretty easy to deploy. And unlike some automatics with a push button, this one right here uses the Axis Auto. And it's pretty easily distinguishable because it's not a button you would go push where you can mistake it with like a pivot. You know, and be trying to hit that pivot when you need it and it ain't coming out. You don't hit this, so your muscle memory is going to always want to pull back. So you're going to know. And plus it's a little sharp. You can kind of feel what's what, you know. And if you do it on this side, it's even that much easier. You pull it out and you just kind of get used to it. So it's a real quick knife to deploy, but you know, I like it a lot. I had to get the auto version. They do have a version with, you know, that regular Axis lock and a thumb stud, but you know, I'm not real crazy about thumb studs. Y'all know that. Now if it had a thumb hole, you know, maybe give it a little bit more angle here and give it a thumb hole. And then we might talk. But I like the auto version. Plus, I don't have a lot of auto knives because they are illegal to carry. And, you know, it's just, it's a real nice knife. Sexy as hell, in my opinion. Look at that, y'all. Good shape. It just kind of goes down here, you know, goes like this. And it got that curvature to it that I like. The handle fits real good in the hand. Kind of makes it where you don't really need a whole lot of grip on the surface because you've got a good grip with the shape of it. And you got some good jimping. You know, it's not the best jimping in the world. It's not like Spyderco good, but, you know, it's good. It'll grip. You know, it'll bite under your finger right there. Same right here, if you look at it. Not super sharp, but, you know, it gives you enough. And you got a little ramp there. Y'all know I like my Spyderco's because of that ramp. This one gives you a little ramp. Of course, you got a pretty heavy belly there, heavy curve. Nice long run of curve right there, 154 cm on the steel. You got an unsharpened area up here. A little bevel, whatever. It's not real sharp, but it feels sharp. I mean, you could get an edge on that relatively quickly if you did want to do that. Of course, not a good idea, you see, because it's exposed, but I'm just saying. You know, it's pretty sharp. Won't cut you though. What that does is, since it got this really nasty tip on it, I mean, that thing is ridiculous. And you know, you got your edge down here, goes up all the way to right about there. See? Pretty healthy edge on it, or a healthy grind, I mean. And then you got this grind up here. And what that does is, when you stick this point into something, you know, you kind of give it that little thrust, this is going to pierce really good. Okay, so that means if you were using this as a self-defense type knife, if you had it in reverse grip, you got a little jimping back here. Kind of get your thumb right back there. Fits good in the hand. Of course, you stab, you got that jimping in that ramp right there to kind of keep, you know, this area right here. And then you got that nice belly so you can slash. And then the natural angle or motion of your arm. It's kind of hard to show right here on the table, but you know, when you slice or, you know, slash, you come back and that tip is always going to be presented at an angle. Kind of, it kind of makes the whole knife work fluidly in a self-defense kind of manner. So you slice, come back, and you can stab, and it's going to want to, you know, stab backwards like that. So if that makes any sense to you, I can show it a lot better than I can explain it at the table here, because I'm, you know, kind of cramped for space. But as far as self-defense, this is an excellent knife for that. Now, if it's against the law to carry this knife where you are, like it is for me, if you use it for self-defense, you will reap, you know, the consequences. You know, you don't want to use an illegal knife for self-defense. So I'm not telling y'all go out and get this for self-defense if it's illegal to carry. I got this for one reason. No, I won't go to jail for it. I probably won't carry it that much. But what I will do is I will play with this knife. I will use this knife around the house. You know, I mean, this knife right here, for me, I can justify the money I spent on it because it's that fucking cool. I just love it. But, I mean, you know, shit ever hits the fan, you know, gets out of control, and I need a good self-defense knife, you know, backup self-defense knife, whatever, I'll probably grab this one. I just really like the ergos on it. This way, reverse it around like that. Good there. But, you know, let's talk about some more stuff on it real quick. Back here, you've got this little area. You know what that looks like, right? That's right. Skull breaker, man. Or glass breaker, if you want to not be so negative about it. But it's a good, nice piece of steel. Like I said, it got some texture, or some cutouts, you know, some jimping. Got your lanyard hole right here. And that thing, you know, it's got a pretty healthy little tip on it, you know. It's not real sharp, but it hurts. You know, you put that on bone, you put that on glass, it's going to break. It's going to shatter. Now, you got a little bit of jimping right back here. Give you a little something extra. Like I said, it's not the best jimping in the world, but, you know, it's functional. Got your pocket clip right here. You can't mount the thing for tip down. In my opinion, on this knife, you would not want to do that. Okay, so you can go tip up on it either side. But of course, if you go tip down, if you could go tip down, you pull the knife out, then you got to reposition it, get up on your axis. This way, carry it tip up. When you pull it out, you're already ready for the axis right here or right here, either way. So it's just much better. So no need to put the clip here or here. So that's good. Got your screw construction. You can take it apart. You know, I look for that in most of the knives I buy. I want to be able to take it apart if I need to. Now back here, you got a little switch. Now y'all probably know what that does. Push it forward. It puts this little piece of metal down there. See that? So what that does is, when that metal goes down, jumps down behind it, you can't pull the axis back, which means you can't deploy the knife. Okay, you can't pull the blade out or nothing like that either. Because If you look, well, actually, I'll show you that in just a minute. I'll show you why. So, you know, that's safety. Now, take it off. Metal comes back up. Now you can deploy your knife. Also, while it's deployed, push it back down again, and guess what? Can't pull the axis to unlock the knife, so it's pretty much locked open. You know, it's going to keep the axis forward for the most part. So, there's that. A little better, in my opinion, that right there is, if you really wanted to make sure it's going to stay safe on you, that's a little better than, you know, just the regular axis locks, or they just got the Omega spring, in my opinion, because you can just drop that metal behind it, and now you got double the protection, in my opinion, so... You know, you may not ever need to rely on the secondary, but possibly the Omega springs if they could fail, you know. Hey, it's just an ongoing paranoia. But, okay, now the reason, if you look at this right here, I don't know if you can see it real good. Most axis locks, a regular axis lock, you can pretty much pull the blade out of the handle. You know, it don't lock into the handle like this one. See, I can't pull that blade out. It's locked in until I pull back because the blade always wants to bias toward open, right? It's always got a constant need to be opened. So that means if I, you know, release the lock, it's like an assisted, you got to pull or you got to push a little bit, then it takes over, you know, about halfway out or a third of the way out. The assisted will take over. This one always wants to be open. As soon as that lock comes back, it lets free of a little, it's a, I don't even know what you want to call it, like the letter C, kind of, you know, in there, little C or something like that, and this bar goes in there. When you pull it back, it pulls the bar, and like I said, this is kind of hard to, you know, see through in the light and all that, but when you pull back like that, it pulls the bar out of that little C or that little channel or whatever. And then, of course, the thing can rotate. And you can kind of see it down there. See that little hook? Right there? Right there where my thumb is. That's a little hook. That's where that axis sets inside there. You see when it goes up, it rotates around. And the axis jumps inside that channel. And keeps that blade locked in there. Even more so when you push the safety on. So, you know, it's a good design. That's the way the axis auto works. And of course, you know, pull that back, get that axis out of the channel. It comes flying around like this. There's your channel. Boom. Now, the axis flies in on the back, on a flat part in the blade, back in there. So, you know, there's your little channel right there. Probably can't see it real good, but it's like a little hook. Either way, I'm just rambling on, but... I think it's really good. I like the fact that, you know, it stays closed like that with that little channel. I don't really think you need the safety on it. As far as that goes, you know, to keep the knife from opening in your pocket. If you carry them like I do, the blade spine here wants to ride against the seam of your jeans anyway. So even if it did open, it would just open a little bit the way I carry them. That's why I like tip-up carry, by the way. Now, you know, you got the safety if you need it, though, if you want it. I do like the fact that it's there whenever you got it open. It's kind of like the CRKT, what do you call it, the locks. You know, the auto locks and the lock system on the CRKTs. You know, the blade comes open, then you just push that, and it, like, you know, doubles your lock, I guess. You know, so that's pretty cool. But either way, auto version, non-auto version, or manual, rather. Either one, the Benchmade Bedlam is a cool knife. Got your G10, got your 154cm, beautiful blade shape. I love that upswept blade shape and that downswept handle. Just makes for an overall good experience whenever you got the knife in your hand. It's a weighty knife. It kind of, you know, it has some heft to it. They did drill out the steel liners in there, you see. But it still has some weight in it, or weight on it, rather. Got a little spacer right here. Well, you know, your spacer back here with the little brain buster. And, you know, it's a little fatter. So it's got some width in your hand when you're holding it. In my opinion, I like that. It makes for a good control of the knife. When you have a thinner knife in your hand, sometimes it wants to torque on you. This one gives you a good control because of the fatness. You know, it gives you that control, and you got the jimping everywhere, back, you know, right here, right here, right here. Got some right there for, you know, this part of your hand. Depends on how you hold it, but just a good blade, y'all. Good blade. I wouldn't spend 20 minutes on it if I didn't think so. Now, I paid like, I think it was like around 170-ish for this with the discount and everything. So for 170, under 200, let's put it. Hey, man, I could not be happier. I really can't find a fault with it. I mean, I really can't. I mean, I gave a little criticism to the Axis style locks, but hey, I've not had a problem with them yet, so, you know. I don't own a lot of Benchmades simply because there's other knives I want more. It's not because they're bad knives. And this one right here, I paid a lot more than a lot of my Spyderco's for this, so, you know, I do like this knife. Now, I don't necessarily recommend this knife, and the reason is, you got to check your local laws and see if an automatic knife is going to be cool for you if you want to carry it. That's not, you know, that's your responsibility. So I'm not going to recommend the knife to everybody. I might recommend the thumb stud version, which I may pick that up. I may end up picking that one up too. But, you know, as far as the knife itself, you know, the style, I can recommend that for a lot of different things. It would do a lot of different things well. I mean, it cuts really well. It's got that belly. And when you get that belly in a knife, you've got a good healthy cutter. You know, you just always got, when you draw the knife through something, it always wants to present that belly into it. So that's good. You got a real wicked piercing tip if you want that too. See, in my opinion, this knife right here is made for combat. You know, it's not really, it's not really an EDC style knife. Could you EDC the damn thing? Hell yeah, you could. You know? I mean, the manual version, you could probably EDC that anywhere. Unless you got blade restrictions, you know, the length. But either way, I recommend the knife for what it is, for the quality, for all that stuff. But like I said, you gotta check your laws. I mean, don't go tell them. You get busted with one of these, and, you know, don't go tell them Exacto told you that he recommended this knife, because that shit ain't going to fly, you know? So, either way, it's a great knife, y'all. I'll quit rambling about it now. If y'all have any questions on it, want to know anything about it, something I didn't cover, whatever, you know how to do it. PM me. Comments down below, whatever you want to do. I'll answer anything I can about it, but this one right here, I'm in love with her. It's a beautiful knife. One more time. Life's short, y'all. Stay sharp.